Hi, hope you guys are doing well. So in the last tutorial I told you that the next tutorial will be about something related to MagicCurl. So we're going to be doing the Wings Club glitter shader in this tutorial, and you can apply it on any sort of material texture you want. It's not just on this material and it's also animated. Okay, so in the viewport it's actually not that much visible, but when I stop it you can actually see that it's actually shining, and you can actually change the shining depending on what you want or how you want it or how much you want it. So let's get started. First I'll just hide this model. Now shift A, okay, shift A, mesh, UV sphere, right click, shade smooth. Since I'm going to be applying it to a material this time, I'm going to give it a material and add in a subdivision surface modifier on it. Okay, so let's go into our material settings. I'll just move it on the side because I want to be able to see everything. So let's go into the shader editor over here, and right now we have the setup, so you can actually use whatever you want. I'll just go with a bluish sort of shade for now, and the principal PSDF isn't important because anything can be used in place of this principal PSDF that can be, you know, plugged in normally. So let's just go into rendered view, and we need a shift A, okay, you can actually call it this by shift A, and search mix shader, okay, and color ramp. Plug in the color of the color ramp into the factor of the mix shader, and I'll just zoom out a bit, move them on the side, and then shift D to duplicate them again because we're going to be needing them again as well, and plug in the mix shader into this output of the output. Okay, and like I said, in this place of this principal BSDF you can use anything you want that you want to mix with the sparkles. Okay, so the principal BSDF is going to be plugged in on the lower part of the mixture and the lower part of the other mixture. Okay, on the lower part of both of the mixtures, and this mixture is going to be plugged into the upper part of the upper one mixture. And now we need a Voronoi texture, a noise texture, a math node, simple math node, okay, and a mapping node, and texture coordinate node. Plugin generated into the vector of the mapping node. Move to the side, and we'll also be needing an emission shader. That reminds me, turn on the bloom on the render settings. Okay, plug in the emission into the upper part of the second emission shader or mix shader, and give it a strength of about 200 because we're mixing it with a simple non-emissive material. It actually needs a lot of it. Okay, so now let's start plugging in the nodes. So plug in the mapping into the vector of both of the noise texture and on the Voronoi texture. Plug in the distance of the Voronoi into the value 1 and value 2, both of the values of the math node. This is the math node which actually just says add because we have this add selected, and instead of add change it to multiply. Now connect the multiply into the color ramp, and plug in the color of the noise texture into the upper color ramp. So now we're going to start moving things on the right places. So move the slider of the color ramp onto the side, and you can actually move this to your own liking. Okay, I'm not saying this is how you 100% you're going to do it, so you can actually tweak a little bit of settings here and then according to your requirement. Move this to actually get a bit of this sort of look, and the scale of the noise texture increase it to like 250. Now you can see that small patches of circular like surfaces, and we sort of want it like this because it is a glitter material. After change the roughness to 0.8 and change the distortion to 1. Now we're going to be looking at the Voronoi, so change the value to about 100. Now it's actually spread across all the way like we wanted it to. Okay, so now if you actually find this too much, you can move this color ramp to move a little bit closer or further away to actually increase the intensity. Okay, like how many of it you want. And also remember, And I think the next step I think is I'll teach you how to animate it. So to animate it on the Warner texture, okay, it's only on the Warner texture, the scale value, on the scale value, move your mouse over here, hover it above, and click on I to add a keyframe. Now it has turned yellow, that means the keyframe has been added, and this yellow diamond also specifies it. So change this to graph editor for some, and you can see this line over here, this line means that a keyframe has been added, and it's actually on the straight, pretty straight line. So you can click on N to actually make this menu appear. If it isn't appeared, it isn't present for you, and go into the modifiers tab. Click on N to make it appear or disappears, and select the modifiers. Then add modifier, and then click on noise modifier. Now, usually this actually changes into a noisy curve, but for some reason it actually doesn't appear over here, but it still affects it like the way I want it to. So I don't know why it's happening. You can change the face to any random value, the scale and the strength to any value if you want to. Okay, but make sure they're not weird, too much different. Like I think a value of 2, 3 to 5 or 10, or is I think around 6 to 7 to 8. I think it's at max, that should be enough, and don't try not to make it that much bigger, okay, because it will actually adversely affect the value. So try not to make them too big, like make them around 5, 7 to 8 at max, and then click on while having a mouse over here, click on T, and this will make disappear, and change it to constant because we actually wanted to move like slashes, okay. So now let's go back into the timeline. And when I play it, you can see that it's actually moving randomly like this. But the thing is, in the viewport, it actually looks a lot less shiny. Okay, there are actually a lot more sparks than we can see. So I recommend that first you take render a single frame, and then you can actually render out the whole thing. So you can obviously lower this to like some extent to make it less visible. When you render it out, it will actually look a little bit more brighter than this. So remember that. 0, 1, 3, 50. So you can actually experiment with the value of what level of sparkle glittering you want. So yeah, so this is how you animate it, and now I'm going to show you how I did it with the other shader. It's not going to take long. So basically, like I said, instead of this principal BSCF, you can plug in anything else you want. So over here, check this model out, the original model, the one I showed you. This also has a principal BSCF plugged in on the same places, but the difference is it also has an image texture. So you can use a texture, you can just simply use a material if you actually want to. So that actually depends upon you. So please leave a like, comment, subscribe to our channel, tell a friend. So see you next time. Goodbye.